Hello, hi. Thank you for finding time to visit Stemstead and Tips. Let's have a look at diabetes. Want to ask ourselves what diabetes? This is a condition that impairs how the body responds to glucose. Otherwise, it's also known as blood glucose. Yes, there are different types of diabetes. We have type 1 diabetes, whereby it's also called juvenile diabetes. It occurs when the body fails to produce insulin. Insulin is a very key hormone produced by the pancreas that is good for the processing of glucose in the body. Yes, so those who have this type of diabetes, they are dependent on insulin, which is artificial, for their daily survival. Another type of diabetes is type 2 diabetes, which is mostly brought up by obesity or lifestyle changes. And this one affects the way the body responds to insulin. Insulin is available, but the body doesn't respond well as it should under normal circumstances. Yes, another thing is gestational diabetes. Gestational diabetes occurs when an expectant mother gets this condition, the blood sugars above the normal, and sometimes it doesn't occur on all women. And also for those who get it, if you have a proper lifestyle, once you deliver your baby, it's done. But if you don't have a healthy lifestyle, it means that this condition is going to be carried forward and you are going to have type 2 diabetes. Yes. Also, we have what we call cystic fibrosis related diabetes. It occurs for those people who have a history of cysts or polycysts in their family history. Back to type 1 diabetes. It can attack the children, it can attack the young adults, and it can attack the elderly. That means that when the body fails to produce enough insulin, it means you are going to have a lot of glucose in your blood, and this glucose is going to impair the proper functioning of your body, and therefore your urine will have sugar. That is why it's called diabetes mellitus, because you will experience sweet urine because of the sugar. And also the hospital remedy is you depend on insulin for a lifetime, which is not an easy thing. Another thing, what are the symptoms and signs? How can I know maybe I'm developing this? Number one, the physical effects include increased hunger and thirst. You've just eaten, but you feel so hungry, like you've not seen food. You've not had any food. You've just taken water, but you're feeling so thirsty. Therefore, this one could be a signal. Another thing is frequent urination, using the bathroom now and then, because it could be because of this condition. Blurred or unclear vision or problems with your sight. You can't see properly. Another thing is tiredness and fatigue. You are so tired, not because you've worked so hard, but because you are experiencing this condition. Another thing is weight loss, frequent weight loss, or losing weight within a short period in a way that you cannot explain. Also, for children, they can experience fever, vomiting, trouble sleeping, wetting of the diaper within a very short time. It could be also a problem with this diabetes. Let's talk about the honeymoon phase. You could be diagnosed with diabetes at the early stages. At this early stage, we call it honeymoon phase, because your body depends on insulin, but not in large quantities. It can be controlled. Therefore, at this point, you can do something. You can ensure that you keep checking on the glucose levels and the insulin levels that you depend on. Another question is, what is the normal blood sugar? Normal blood sugar is between 99 milligrams per deciliter, 70 to 99 milligrams per deciliter. Yeah. A person with a diabetic fasting sugar of 126 milligrams per liter and above, it means that person is diabetic. Yes. We have another condition called pre-diabetics. Pre means before, meaning before you are diagnosed that you are diabetic. You could be, your blood sugars are so high, but you've not been diagnosed as diabetic. What does that mean? It means if your blood sugars are high and you have a very little opportunity to get into being diabetic. And in this condition, people are at risk of developing type 2 diabetes. Therefore, you may not be experiencing the symptoms, but your blood sugars are high. That's why it's good to have regular checkups at the hospital to keep your blood sugars on check. What are the risk factors for prediabetics and diabetes type 2? What can expose you to this diabetes if you are almost getting into it? Number one, being overweight. It's good to keep check of your weight, because when you are overweight, you are at risk. A family history of diabetes, having a high density lipoprotein, that is what we call the HDL cholesterol, a level that is below 40 milligrams per deciliter or 50 milligrams per deciliter. HDL is the good glucose that the body needs to function properly. And also we have LDL, which is the low density lipoprotein, which is not so good to the body in high amounts. Yes, having gestational diabetes, the one we talked about. Another thing, or giving birth to a child who is more than 9 pounds. Also having a family history of polycystic ovarian cysts, it could also put you at risk of this condition. Also, research says if you are more than 45 years of age, though, however, these days it's even coming to the lower generation, the young people, therefore it doesn't spare anyone. Another thing is having a sedentary lifestyle. Your workplace is just going to sit in the office, swing on a chair, day is over, you go home, eat, sleep. You see that kind of life. It puts you at risk of getting this condition. Therefore, it's good to have regular exercise. Even if your nature of work is that of sitting, have breaks in between work and even jog. You can sometimes use walk on foot to stage instead of taking shortcuts like motorbikes and all those. How do insulin problems occur? How does it happen that the body starts to not responding to insulin or not producing enough insulin? This is how it occurs. Insulin allows the glucose from a person's food to access the cells in their body to supply energy. That's the work of insulin hormone. Insulin resistance is usually as a result of the following cycle. Number one, a person has genes or an environment that make it more likely that they are unable to make enough insulin to cover how much glucose they eat. And like, you are eating more glucose than your body can be able to process. That is the danger. Number two, the body tries to make extra insulin to cater for this increased demand of processing glucose, but it is not able to make enough insulin. Therefore, the pancreas cannot keep up with this increased demand. What happens? The excess blood sugar starts to circulate in the blood, causing damage. Remember, our blood doesn't want to have excess sugar. The current health crisis we are having of COVID-19. Research says that the diabetic people are at risk because this virus likes sweet blood. It thrives well in a blood that has high sugar. Therefore, we need to keep check on our sugar levels to ensure we are safe from this pandemic. And how can we do that? By keeping check on our blood sugar levels, by ensuring we don't eat enough excess carbohydrates. But stay tuned, we learn how to best do that right here at STEMSA. Yes, another thing is, over time, insulin becomes less effective at introducing glucose to cells. And what happens? Blood sugar levels continue to rise. Point to note, excess glucose results to diabetes mellitus, as we already said. And that other thing, boom blood sugar level by a sweet puts someone at risk of getting headache. Another thing, apple get blood sugar levels to the required level without having these headaches. And you are wondering, how can I be sure I keep check of my sugar levels? How do I help? Now already I am diabetic, or I have someone who is diabetic. How am I going to help this person? Stay tuned right here at STEMSA and Tips. We are going to tackle home remedies for diabetes type 2, how to prevent and how to treat it, and also how to check on our insulin levels. Don't miss us in the next video. Please subscribe to ensure that you get it and you are able to check on your blood sugar levels in the required amount. God bless you and keep tuning in for more. Thank you.